Takadimi, ta di taka di ta dimi ta dimi taka. We taka dimi taka dimi taka. Takadimi, ta dimi taka dimi ta di Takadimi, ta dimi taka dimi ta dimi. Yo, Kadimi Takadimi Takadimi Taka Mi Takadimi Takadimi Taka Mi Takadimi 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 Taka Takadimi 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 Takadimi.
Hello, my favorite music students. It's me, Mr. Gessler, back at the Red Studio. I want to welcome any of you who are joining us for the first time, particularly fourth grade. I know some of you have been with us for the last couple episodes, but I've invited all of fourth grade to join us now, so welcome aboard. Today we're talking about subdivision, which is the next level down in our rhythms. We've worked with beat, we've worked with division, and today we're working with subdivision. But first, a word about Takadimi, this strange system that we've been using. Why Takadimi? It seems so, like, awkward. Ta, 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 di, ta. It's like cringy, as some of you like to say. Well, Takadimi is actually just a counting system, and it was never meant to be performed. And it's actually just one of many counting systems. When you were younger, we would use ta and titi, and we probably never got to tika tika, but it's part of the same system. So let's say you're looking at a piece of music like this one, and we're going to count the rhythm. It would sound something like this. Ta ti ti tika tika ta ta ti ti ta. Shh. Some of you have used count singing. I know I've heard some of you do it. That's where you say the number of the beat and you divide the beat with the word and. And we won't talk about the subdivision so much, but you'll hear it in this same piece of music. One, two, and three, and a four. One, two, and three. Then there's something called Gordon syllables, which kind of sounds funny the first time you hear it. It's about as awkward as Takadimi. It sounds like this. Do, do, de, do, ta, de, ta, do, 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 de, do. Yeah, that one's fun when you get into compound because then you get to sing do, bobby, do, bobby.
Do, bobby, do, bobby.
All of these systems work as long as you use them correctly, and each one has a different advantage. Kind of like different tools. It's just, which one do you need for this job? I have a pretty standard ruler here. I've had this one for years, come to think of it. What was I, like 19 when I bought this? Anyway, it's 12 inches long, standard ruler. And it's marked 12 inches at the top. But it's also marked 30 and a half centimeters. Well, which one is it? It's both. We're just using two different languages, two different systems to describe how long this ruler is. But at the end of the day, the ruler is this long. It's kind of like that when we choose Takadimi or Gordon or counting. Most of the time, you and I will be working with Takadimi. Okay, imagine it's 2014 and you are a young actor or actress in New York City. You get a call from Lin-Manuel Miranda's agent asking if you would like to be in the chorus of his new musical called Hamilton. How are you going to learn your part? You can't learn the songs by watching YouTube videos because in 2014, nobody had recorded any of these songs. You're going to be part of the original recording. Now, I don't know if Lin-Manuel Miranda is classically trained. I don't know if he writes music or not. He might have written them down on paper. He might have recorded them into his phone. He might have done it on his computer. But I bet you he's not going to send a bunch of voice messages to your phone so you can learn the part. He's going to send you a score. Yeah, not like a basketball score. A score is basically a script or a roadmap for music. It's pages and pages of notation and lyrics. How do you begin to learn your part? You begin with the rhythm, especially in rap and hip-hop music, which is all about rhythm. Even in other genres of music, the words and the pitches are super important, but you don't know where to put them unless you know the rhythm. Take this piece of music, for example. There's plenty of information on this page. Where do we begin? Well, I can see that it's written for a rock organ. I can see that we are in 4-4 time, so there are going to be four beats in each measure, and each beat will be as long as a quarter note. This is where we need our rhythm tools, and the tool we're using today is Takadimi. And this one is simple, you already know how to read it. Ta, ta, di, ta, ta, di, ta, ta, ta. Shh. In case you're confused, there are two things going on at the same time. One is my steady beat, it doesn't change. One, two, three, four. The other is this rhythm that's written into the music with ta and ta-di, sometimes one sound on a beat, sometimes two sounds on a beat. But the rhythm rides over top of the beat and interlocks with it. So now that we know the rhythm, we can add the pitches, and there are two sets of pitches here, so let's go with the top one first. We're gonna use Mr. Malarney's tool of the lines being the fingers on our hand, starting at the bottom. Every good boy does fine and cares. So we're looking for this top ledger line. Every good boy does fine and. So we have an A at the top. That's right here. A, G, F, E, D, C, B. Back up to C, and then another C. But now I'm going to make it line up with the rhythm that we just said. So our rhythm is here. Ta, ta, di, ta, ta, di, ta, ta, ta. Shh. A, G, F, E, D, C, B, C, C. Ta, ta, di, ta, ta, di, ta, ta, ta. What makes this tricky is that we're thinking about the rhythm and we're adding pitches to it. Here's the second voice. It's at our top line, so we're gonna think every good boy does fine. This second voice begins with an F. I'm gonna read the notes as we go down. F, E, D, C, B flat, A, G, F, E. Different notes, but the rhythm is exactly the same, so these are gonna sound at the same time. So first, let's apply our rhythm to these notes, starting on F. Ta, ta, di, ta, ta, di, ta, ta, ta. F, E, D, C, B flat, A, G, F, E. So now we're gonna play both sets of notes simultaneously while thinking of this rhythm. Ta, ta, di, ta, ta, di, ta, ta, ta. Shh. So now I need to play it up to tempo. Got my metronome here, plugged into my headphones. So maybe you have no plans to work on Broadway someday, or maybe you're not the Beatles, but if you're in band at school, you've probably read a score before. And if you're in chorus, you probably will be asked to read a score soon if you haven't already. Don't be scared of it. It's actually kind of thrilling once you get the hang of it. It's like understanding a secret code. Okay, time for a quick vocabulary lesson. A prefix is a short fragment of a word that starts at the beginning of a word and usually changes its meaning a little bit. The three-letter prefix sub means under or below. So you can get to work the regular way, or you can take the subway, which goes underground. By the way, this subway came before this subway. Sub-zero means less than zero, or below zero. Subplot means a plot or storyline that's working underneath the main plot. So just by substituting a prefix, you change the meaning substantially. But I submit you are already subconsciously aware of all this, so I don't mean to subject you to a boring subpar YouTube video. And that finally brings us to our topic of subdivision. We've talked about simple and compound beat and division. Today we're going to keep things simple and just stick with simple division. So remember, simple division is when your beat can be divided into two parts. That usually means a quarter note being divided into two eighth notes. Simple division means you can divide it in two parts. Subdivision is the next level down below division. So if we have a beat that's divided into two parts, it is subdivided into four parts. Okay, let's see if we can find a way to explain this. Think of it like a pizza. Yeah, a pizza. Let's say one whole pizza is one measure of music. If I split a pizza with three of my sisters, we're each gonna get 1/4 of the pizza, or 1/4 of the pizza, right? So there are four quarters in this measure. There are four quarters in this pizza. Yeah, there are four quarters in the pizza. Some of you are like, three sisters, who does that? Just wait. What if my four other sisters showed up? Now we have to split our quarter slices in half, and we each get 1/8 of the pizza. We're gonna call this the division. We've broken every quarter of the pizza into 2/8. So now we have 8/8 of our pizza. Still one whole, still 4/4, but 8/8 as well. and we usually like to group notes together to show that they're in the same beat, like this. We still have four beats, or four quarters, but each quarter is broken in half. Well, now we have a party. But what if my four brothers show up and they bring their wives with them? Now we have 16 people to feed, so the eight of us are gonna cut our pieces in half again, and now we have 16 miserable little slivers. Whoa, 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 that's a lot of notes to keep track of. Can we make this a little bit simpler? Yeah, let's group them together. So we'll put four 16th notes here, four 16th notes here, four here, and four here. Okay, now I can see there are four sounds on each beat, and there are four beats. And to make it just a little bit clearer that they're together, let's put a beam across all four 16th notes. There we go. Is nobody gonna claim that pepperoni? Wait, what if my siblings all brought their kids? So only 16 of them are old enough to eat pizza anyway, so we're gonna take our 16 miserable slivers and cut them in half again and end up with 32 pieces of pizza. No, we are not. I'm not even gonna waste my time on the graphics because who cuts their pizza 32 ways? Come on, this is America. Order another pizza. Support local restaurants. Takeout is still legal. Besides, there are already too many people here. We're not supposed to have any more than 10, so like 22 of you need to go home. We'll see you online. No fun. Look at it another way. Think of this really long Lego brick as being one measure. I want you to notice that there are 16 little bumps or nodes on this Lego. Let's continue to play with 4-4 time, which means we're going to break the long Lego into four parts or four quarters. And of course, we know exactly what to say when we see one of these. Ta, 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 ta. Okay, we know this. Good. But notice that we still have 16 little bumps even on our four quarter notes. Now we're literally going to divide these Legos in half. So we're turning all of our quarter notes into two eighth notes. So now we have two sounds on each beat. Ta-di, 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 ta-di. You guys know this stuff. Here's the new guy, subdivision. We're dividing even the eighth notes in half. If you divide one eighth note in half, you get two 16th notes. So now splitting all of our eighth notes in half, we end up with 16 16th notes, but they're still grouped into four beats. We still have 16 little bumps. In our Takadimi counting system, we literally say Takadimi when we see 16th notes grouped together like this. That's how Takadimi got its name. Now, I know I'm corny, but I did not make this system up. Let's try this a few times. Takadimi, 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 Takadimi. Believe it or not, this is going to be super helpful. But here's something wonderful you might have noticed. No matter whether we're saying the beat, ta, the division of the beat, ta di, or the subdivision of the beat, Takadimi, we're still saying ta on the beat. That is a wonderful thing, because I know every time the word ta comes out of my mouth, that's exactly where the beat is. So I can line up the word ta with the steady beat that I'm feeling in my body. You might also have noticed that whenever we say ta-ka-di-mi, we're still saying ta and di. We just shoved a ka in the middle and put a mi at the end. Ta-ka-di-mi. What happens when we mix and match some beat, some division, and some subdivision? Well, here's a song you might know. I see four 16th notes on the first beat, so I'm going to say Takadimi. The rest are easy. Remember, the rhythm rides over top of the beat and interlocks with it. So every time I say ta, it's going to fall right on that beat. We can't just read this like a sentence in whatever time we want. That's my metronome. One, two, ready, go. Takadimi, ta-di, ta-di, ta-di. Good. Now try it without me. One, two, ready, go. Just in case you didn't quite pick it up that time, we're going to do it again. One, two, ready, go. Don't recognize the song yet? That's okay. I haven't given you a lot of information yet. Take a look at this one. Now, when we say Takadimi on these 16th notes, we're gonna have to say it pretty fast because we have to fit it into the space of one beat. It might make the ta feel like it's too slow. It should take us just as long to say ta as it does to say Takadimi. One, two, ready, go. Ta, Takadimi, ta, Takadimi. Feels awkward at first, doesn't it? Let's try it again. One, two, ready, go. Ta, Takadimi, ta, Takadimi. Okay, you try it by yourself. One, two, ready, go. Okay, last line before we put them all together. This one is easier. There's no Takadimi here, and our old friend Shush is back. One, two, ready, go. Ta-dee-ta-dee-ta. Shh. Okay, now just you. One, two, ready, go. Let's put it all together. I'm going to take out the words, the Takadimi sounds, because you know what to do at those spots. If you see a quarter note, you say ta. If you see two eighth notes, you say ta-di. If you see four sixteenth notes, you say Takadimi. And let's make sure we do the top line twice. Okay, here we go. One, two, ready, go. Takadimi, ta-di, ta-di, ta-di. Takadimi, ta-di, ta-di, ta-di. Ta, Takadimi, ta, Takadimi, ta-di, ta-di, ta. Still don't recognize the song? Okay, I'm going to put some pitches on it. I think I need my other headphones for this. I'm just doing this so I can stay in tune. One, two, ready, go. Takadimi, ta-di, ta-di, ta-di. Takadimi, ta-di, ta-di, ta-di. Ta, Takadimi, ta. Takadimi, ta-di, ta-di, ta. Okay, now you know how to read rhythms with simple subdivision. Kanye West started his career as a producer, and he still likes to collaborate with other artists like Chance the Rapper, Lil Wayne, and yes, even Kenny G. What if he wanted to collaborate with you? What if he sent you a piece of music and asked you to learn it? Where do you begin? You begin with the rhythm, especially in rap and hip-hop music, which is all about rhythm. Yes, I'm repeating myself. You could start with the lyrics just to sort of get a sense for the song.
Life like, this is what your life like. Try to live your life right. People really know you, push your buttons like a typewriter.
But once you've scanned the lyrics, you still have to go back and learn the rhythm of the song. Okay, cool, we can do that. The meter says 2/4, so there will be two beats in each measure, and each beat will be as long as a quarter note. I don't see any quarter notes in this song. All the beats have either two sounds or four sounds. If I see this, I'll say ta-di. If I see this, I'll say Takadimi. Try it with me. We'll start at a slow tempo. One, two, ready, go. Ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, Takadimi, Takadimi. That's the first four measures. Now let's take a good deep breath and see if we can go all the way to the end. Ready? Two, three, and go. Ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, 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 ta-di, Takadimi, 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 ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, 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 ta-di, Takadimi, 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 ta-di, Takadimi, Takadimi, ta-di, ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, and I'm out of music. Now let's try it with the mix that Kanye sent you in your email. Be warned, it's quite a bit faster. One, two, three, and. Ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, 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 ta-di, Takadimi, 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 ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, Takadimi, ta-di, and that's far enough for now. Okay, the next part is fun. We need to line up the words with the rhythms that we just said. So every time we have one syllable in a word, we're going to put it with one sound or one note in our notation. For example, our first beat has two sounds, ta-di, and two words or two syllables, life-like. So we're going to say the words life-like in the same rhythm as ta-di. Then the next beat has four sounds on it, Takadimi, and surprise, it has four syllables. This is what you're. So we have Ta-di-takadimi. I'm going to put those words on it like this. Life-like, this is what you're. One syllable on each sound. Let's jump to measures 3, 4, and 5. Here we have sort of a complete sentence. So we're going to try putting the words on this rhythm. We'll go a little bit slower. One, two, ready, go. Takadimi, 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 ta-di. Okay, we can handle that. Let's put those words on it. Still kind of slow. One, two, ready, go. People really know you push your buttons like a typewriter. Takadimi, 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 Ta-di. People really know you push your buttons like a type, right? And again, this is eventually going to be faster. Takadimi, 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 Ta-di. People really know you push your buttons like a type, right? The words line up exactly with the rhythm. Okay, I'm going to try the whole thing with the loop that Kanye sent to me in my email. This is all just sort of imaginary. I'm not actually friends with Kanye. I am not a rapper, but I can read rhythms, and so can you. Life like, this is what your life like. Try to live your life right. People really know you push your buttons like a type, right? This is like a movie, but it's really very lifelike.
Every single night, right? Every single fight, right? I was looking at the gram and I don't even like likes. I was screaming at my dad, he told me ain't that Christ-like. I was screaming at the referee, just like Mike. Looking for a bright light, singing, what?
Riding on a white bike, feeling like a sight bike. Pressing on a gas, supernova for a night light. Screaming at my dad and he told me it ain't Christ. Like, but nobody never tell you when you're being like Christ. Only ever seeing me, only when they need me.
Most of the time, the music that you see will not be carefully laid out in groups of Ta-Di and Takadimi. A lot of times there will be mixes of 1/8 note and 2/16 on the same beat. We'll talk about that later. A lot of times there'll be syncopation where the notes kind of slide around a little bit. So it's good to start with something like this. If we can read this really well, we'll be able to build up to the next level. In fact, on the Google Classroom assignment, there will be 8 questions for you to recognize different rhythms. And at the end, you will have the opportunity to read this music along with Kanye's record. I say record as if anybody ever uses those anymore. Speaking of Google Classroom, I'm seeing some improvements on there. Let's take a look at some stats. It's not like there's anything going on in professional sports right now, so let's have some fun with stats. Oop, that's the wrong password. Don't look. Give it time. The more we talk about this stuff, the more it's going to make sense to you. So I want to make you guys an offer. If I get 100 students to respond to the Google Classroom assignment, I will shave my beard. And then I'll take a picture and I'll grow it right back really fast. Because I look weird without a beard. Okay, shifting gears just a little bit here. I know that a lot of you are struggling with the fact that school is online right now. It means more reading. It means it's harder to get help. It means you don't get to see your friends very much or at all. It's kind of like being grounded all the time, only you didn't do anything wrong. Some of you are probably worried about what's going on in the world, and some of you are probably really sensitive to the bad news that you're hearing all the time. It does help to focus on good news as much as possible, but it also helps to grieve a little bit. What do I mean by that? Well, grieving is a little bit different from complaining. Complaining says, I have a problem and you have to do something about it, or even, I'm upset with you until you do something about my problem. Grief is more just like recognizing that you're in pain. It's just noticing the hurt, especially when you can't do anything about it. If you've ever lost someone that you love, even like a family pet, you know what grief is like, and you've experienced it. But sometimes it helps to grieve little things too. Maybe you're disappointed about a canceled field trip, or maybe you're a little bit irritated because you don't get to see your friends that much. Maybe you're sad because you feel like this whole shelter-in-place thing is never going to end. Talk to somebody about it. Be really honest with yourself. Am I just cranky today, or am I angry because sixth grade is not going the way that I hoped it would? Being really honest about our pain is a good first step toward feeling better. I'll tell you, this coronavirus pandemic will come to an end at some point. Most of the adults in your life have been through something like this before. Talk to them. Tell them what's on your mind. I love you guys. I pray for you. I hope to see you again soon. I just want to add two more notes here. First, I want to thank all of you students and all of the parents and all the teachers and administrators who have sent me emails and encouraged me and told me how much you like the videos. That's awesome because I'm having fun making them and it really helps to hear your feedback. Second, if you have any experience with dance, I'm thinking way down the road, we will have our Halloween parade as usual, which includes a dance. And if you're in sixth grade, I know you won't be part of that next year, but if you have some choreography experience, I would love your input on what we can do. Fifth grade, you will be in sixth grade by that point, so if you have some dance experience, please throw ideas at me. I'm looking for not an entire choreographed song, but I'm looking for song suggestions. I'm looking for dance moves, because as much as I enjoy dance, I'm not very good at it, and I don't have a large vocabulary of dance moves. So between your experience and my experience, we should be able to put together something good. Keep in mind that most of it has to be something that everybody can learn. See you next time. Email me with any questions. Have a great week.
It's gonna be bad, guys. Because life like, this is what your life's like, trying to live your life right. People really know you pushing buttons type right. This is the movie, but it's really very lifelike. Every single night right, every single fight right. I was looking at the gram and I don't even like likes. I was screaming at my dad, he told me ain't that Christ-like. I was screaming at the referee, just like Mike, looking for a bright light, singing, what?